What's up, y'all? I'm Drew Morrissey, and this is How to Rap.
Fuck being on some chill shit. We go 0 to 100, nigga, real quick. They be on that rap to pay the bill shit. And I don't feel that shit, not even a little bit. Oh, Lord, know yourself, know your worth, nigga. My actions being louder than my words, nigga.
Okay, so today we're going to talk about a song that's just bubbling in the streets right now. It's in the clubs, it's in your car, it's on your iPods, it's on your iTunes. And that is Drake's 0 to 100. And before I start to break down some of the rap and technical side of it, I just want to point you to, as a person that's trying to be an up-and-coming MC, trying to be someone familiar with how to drop these hot street anthems, the way that the song is recorded. Now, if you listen to Drake's verses on this song and the chorus and the way he repeats himself, there's not much going on with the engineering. It's just a dude rapping. There's not a lot of ad-libs. There's no doubles whatsoever, to be honest. And there's just a slight echo on certain cool words, you know.
Oh, she gonna see some shit that she don't wanna see. She ain't ready for it. If I ain't the greatest, then I'm headed for it. Yeah, that mean I'm way up. Yeah, the six ain't friendly, but that's where I lay up.
So he's just a guy rapping over the top of a hot beat. And a lot of rappers are doing this now. So what I believe is happening is basically, when you're listening to this song in any context, whether it's the club, whether it's your phone, whether it's your car, you're just focused on the lyrics itself because there's not so much ad-libs and backgrounds, horns and voices. Now, some other rappers like a T.I. or Ross can get away with that, but Drake specifically, he's starting to use engineering as a way for his voice to have real effectiveness just straight up without all the bells and whistles. And I think that's one of the things that stands out about this song is the choices in mixing and engineering. So his voice takes prominence over everything else. Now, another thing that stands out about this song is the identifiable phrases that he repeats over and over, almost like a cycle, where
fuck being on some chill shit. We go 0 to 100, nigga, real quick. They be on that rap to pay the bill shit. And I don't feel that shit, not even a little bit. Oh, Lord.
0 to 100, nigga, real quick. Or, oh, Lord. I mean, this dude says about 4 or 5 times, and not even just like it's a chorus, but like it's a new phrase. And that's what I want you to take away from this song, is you can come up with a phrase for people to say that they can use in different contexts and have a nice little like vocal twist to it. So like, oh Lord, which people just say all the time, but in that tone, oh Lord, like Drake has now put that in the forefront, or 0 to 100, and they go real quick. The way that he uses that specific phrase now has inserted itself in popular culture already. So when you listen to this song and you're thinking about me as an upcoming MC, one of the things I want you to do is think, how could I take a common phrase that could be used in different contexts, like 0 to 100, like oh Lord, and add a nice little twist vocally to it to make it my own and make it stand out. So listen to the phrases in this song, whole squad on that real shit. Another perfect example, and take something from it from what you can do. Now you obviously don't want to actually make your song 0 to 100 or 0 to 60, but you should find your own ways to make that stand out. Now the last thing I should talk about, of course, is the second part of the song. And what I want you to get out of this second part and the relationship between the two parts of the song, there's two things. Now the first point is, his vocal tone changes and you should be studying the way that he manipulates his voice on the street anthem side of the song versus the slower, reflective side of the song.
Fuck all that Drake, you gotta chill shit. I be on my little mouse drill shit. Fuck all that rap to pay your bill shit. Yeah, I'm on some rap to pay my bill shit. Whole squad on that real shit. Yeah. The other night, Lavish Lee told me that I'm all these people listen to. She said they love me unconditional. Imagine how I feel to watch another nigga at the top. You know that if you wasn't you, you would be dissing you, dog.
You as an MC have to be a master at manipulating your voice so that when there's a deeper, more serious part of the song, the audience feels that and they understand the vibe is switched. And Drake is an expert at that. So when I'm listening to the first part of 0 to 100, and he's like, oh Lord, you made me kill one of the ghosts for it, boy. I got all hits. He's using a fun street kind of vocal tone. But then when the second part comes on, and he's like, you know, he lowers his voice, he gets more like he's having a one-on-one conversation, it fits more with the slower, chiller beat on the second part. Now, the second thing I want to point out about the second side of the song, which I heard apparently was supposed to be its own song called The Catch Up, but he mixed it together, is the lyrics themselves are telling you about Drake's life and Drake's world on both sides, to be honest, but specifically on the second part. He mentions his team is about to drop all these albums. He mentions OVO. He talks about we already got Spring 2015 popping. Think about that from a promotional standpoint. Now, I know there are all these artists on OVO that Drake is planning to drop, not to mention him dropping, as he said. And now I know that there's a world, a crew, and like a vibe that's about to come out. So Drake has just brought you into that world. He talks about his past on the first part of this song, Comeback Season. If you didn't know what that was, his first mixtape, like now you know.
Man, it's 2008, I'm trying to paint the picture. Comeback season in the works and now I'm thinking bigger. I got 40 in the studio, every night, late night. Gotta watch that shit, don't wanna make him sicker. That's my nigga, oh Lord.
He's describing exactly what his life was like. And you as a rapper and for your own career, you should do the same. I should know where you came from. I should know what mixtapes you dropped and how was your relationship with your producer, as he mentions with his man 40. How is it going now? What's gonna happen in spring 2015 for you? Use the tactics that Drake's using for your own life. Obviously don't rap about his life, but rap about your own. But use all these things. So I want you to think a lot about the mixing and possibly not having any ad-libs at all, just rap. And then maybe have a little cool echo. I want you to think about the phrases that you're using to get people to relate. Is it catchy and easy to say, like 0 to 100, nigga, real quick? Or, oh Lord. And I want you to bring people into your life. I need to know, you know, what it was like 3 years ago when you first started rapping in this place. What's it gonna be like 3 years from now when you have your team and you're about to drop X, Y, and Z? Like, tell me about that. And that's one of the most effective things about 0-200. And these are things that are going to be effective for you long term as an MC. And of course, not to mention, the beats are tight as shit. I mean, like, straight up, there's a reason that everybody has a 0-200 freestyle right now in the industry. It's because that first beat is crazy. And of course, the second beat is like pretty deep and nice too. So also, added bonus point, get hot beats. It'll help your career. I'm sure that's why you're watching my videos, just to hear things like get hot beats. Anyway, I'm Drew Marcy. I'm about to enjoy the rest of my day out here in LA. I hope this was useful to you. Stay tuned, many more to come. I'm all around Instagram, Twitter, add me and all that shit too. I'm Drew Marcy, and I just taught you how to rap. Peace.
I run this shit, they like go for us, run for us, run for us, go for us. Yeah, I mean, y'all already wrote for us. Damn, nigga, what's one more quote for us? Oh, Lord.